craziness. I'm not dissing, bro. I'm just saying the guy on TED Talk talking about drugs and the brain and the confidence and self and stuff like that. His shit is good. It's credible to me because I've been through it and I know what the fuck he's talking about. But to the person that like doing it, I don't think he ever did alcoholic. I mean, he never did addict, bro, because of the fact that I don't think he had the sponsor, or he did it this way, or he did it that way. You know what I mean? It's just weird. It just sounds like he did drugs, went through school, and has an opinion, that valid opinion. But he didn't do the system, though. He didn't do the dip, so he can't qualify to say or speak on the topic because he didn't knownfully do it. You know what I mean? Like, he didn't knownfully do the AA or NA. I did the step. I can say what the fuck I want to say. Because the truth is, I did the dip, and I know what works for me and what doesn't work for me. You know, I'm taking it as an individual. But the only thing I'm saying is, I mean, it's like all that credibility in a world of science, bro, in a world of study. You can talk about shit all day. It could be valid to some extent. But I don't think he was an addict, bro. You know, because of the fact that that it's just he graduated college. You wouldn't have graduated shit. You know what I mean? You would have been too busy fighting all kinds of other shit. And it just sounds unbelievable. I'm grateful because this shit makes sense. But what I'm saying is, you got to show both sides, bro. You know, the whole like the whole system, the whole process, the spirituality. So what happens is, I guess the alcoholic has one system and one condition, and so does NA have one system and one condition. What he did is he came out with another condition, and it was validated. But what gave him the right to create a new condition in the world of addiction? Like, what gave him that right? Because of the fact that, you know, me as a kid, my condition was, oh, mom, I smoked weed, and everybody's being weird, you know what I mean? And that was the end, and that was the condition, you know, that everybody was being weird until I snitched on myself. So I was, like, thinking, him having to be in a world of science and being on TED Talk, like, what made it so credible, you know what I mean? Because you have to know the medical. That's before you, like before yourself, medical opinion, and then you have to be treated, you know, and then you have to go through the social systems to understand the whole disease. Like, it's not a person disease. It's like it's a social thing. You know what I mean? It's a social illness because, I mean, I saw what he was saying, and I got to that point, and the thing about it is this. How do you stop the coursing, bro? You know what I mean? Because of the fact that, you know, I have trust in myself. I know myself. I know I don't want to do that. I know what it is. I believe what you're saying because I'm going through that. But what I'm saying is it doesn't show the social effects of addiction. You know what I mean? Because he didn't knownfully speak on the process of the treatment that he was going through. So it doesn't really make his say valid as an addict. You know what I mean? Like, had he done the steps knownfully, he would be more valid, you know what I mean? And both sides, me being a person who quit on being an addict, bro, I know what I'm saying, because, you know, it makes sense. But see, being outside of the body, the alcoholic body or the addictive body, it shows you that it's a condition that people put themselves into. You know what I mean? And this guy created a new condition, which I agree with it. But at the same time, it's like, what gave him the like what validated it, you know? And then how come it's not credible overall? You know what I mean? Otherwise, we would have been into this addiction shit yesterday. But I don't know. I'm just saying, like, you know, the medical term, that means him not being a doctor, being treated as such. You know, that would have validated his addiction. Him being in some type of treatment, you know, that would have validated his, you know, addiction. Him being in some type of social group for addiction would have, you know, would have done it. But so I guess he didn't do addict right. or he didn't do a he didn't do drugs right, I guess. It's weird, cause it's a whole thing, bro. It's a whole world, it's a whole dimension. People don't understand that shit, you know what I mean? And then it's the quest to get away from their world. But anyway, so I don't know. I was just thinking about the social effects and those things, cause those are the things that hurt even more, you know what I mean? Than the psychological, because some people will be crazy and be social as fuck, you know what I mean? And there's people that just wouldn't be social and be sane, you know? It's crazy. But so it's just I think he's speaking about one type of addict. I do agree with what he's saying, it is beneficial, but what I'm saying is, to make him more credible, he needs to speak on his personal treatment and how he was treated for his illness, because you can't go from being sick to saying this is the cure, bro. You know what I mean? That's why, like, yeah, like it's just crazy, bro. It's like saying I had cancer yesterday. Okay, this pill cures cancer. Okay, but how did you get treated though, motherfucker? I don't give a, before we get to this pill, how were you treated for your cancer, bro? If you know, shit like that, you know what I mean? It's crazy. So that's what I'm saying when it comes to these credibilities. Is like, you can't go from being addict to being dropping the science right there. He would have been on the streets. They would have been made an example of him with drugs. He wouldn't have been able to do it like that. And that's the stuff he needs to show that validates his study. But I guess, it's, I don't know. It's crazy, man. But I am taking some tools from him, and he is saying some real stuff. That mental shit is crazy. That's just one symptom of addiction. If one symptom is that mental thing, that's just one symptom. Imagine just one symptom of that mental stuff with the brain slash or whatever. That's just one symptom. What about the economical? What about the financial? What about the social? What about the faithful? What about the religious body, or, you know, geographical area? So that is just one symptom, dude. But I just wanted them to be credible, you know, because it's worth knowing, you know. That shit is crazy, those TED talks. But yeah, to make these fools credible, I would say just do the step work or some shit, you know. And, you know, fuck, it's crazy. Because otherwise they say you weren't a real addict, you were fake and shit, all this and all that. I mean, whatever it takes to be done, right? Fuck it. How'd you end the coursing is what I wanted to know, you know? It's crazy. I don't like to beat people up because drugs beat you up anyways and they make you a little pussy against yourself. So, I don't know. I'll take it the faith way, because faith did it yesterday. Faith did it yesterday, so I'll take it that way. But anyways, that's why I'm talking shit, bro, because I did it all the other ways. And to the T, bro, that little T, I like that. So that's why I'm saying that. So I hate addiction, bro. I hate coursing, bro. I just hate drug, period, bro. You know what I mean? Cause when I know there's a natural way to feel the effect. You know what I mean? It's crazy. It's called earn or something. It's crazy. I need to be more known, you guys.